Busy and consequential day at the state capitol. Governor Jared Polis signing 4 gun violence prevention bills into session today. Rather, signing them into law today. They were passed this session. The bills give families more flexibility to sue gun manufacturers, expand the list of who can file a petition through the state's red flag law.
And it also creates a 3-day waiting period to purchase a gun and increases the minimum age to buy any gun in the state. But gun rights groups are already reacting. FOX 31 political reporter Gabrielle Franklin has more from the capitol. Gabrielle.
Yeah, Talia, almost immediately after these new measures were signed into law, Rocky Mountain gun owners already filed lawsuits against 2 of them. The gun rights group is suing over the law that introduces a 3-day waiting period for gun purchases in Colorado, as well as the law raising the age to 21 to buy any type of firearm in the state. Now, they said they are not filing suits against the other 2 measures because they don't have cause for lawsuits against those just yet. Meanwhile, outside the state capitol, families of gun violence victims and advocates celebrated today's bill signings as a win that they say was decades in the making.
You weren't going to sit on your ass while watching so many Coloradans succumbing to gunfire. You were determined to do something about it. And especially those who came here, the students, who said very clearly, we don't want to live like this.
We don't want our members to ever be affected by these unconstitutional laws. So we made sure that we filed our lawsuits as soon as the pen hit the paper to make sure, and that's the promise that we've been giving to our members, right? So we wanted to make sure this was never in effect in Colorado.
So on top of the bills that we just told you about that were signed into law today, state senators were also able to pass a ghost gun measure. That's a concept that the governor is willing to get behind, but that measure still has to go through the state house here at the Capitol. Reporting live outside the state capitol, Gabrielle Franklin, FOX 31. Gabrielle.